السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Good morning my student. أنا اسمي لابور. How are you today? Today we are need to talk about fluids in motion as you see and Bernoulli equation. It's an important equation and important topic in our LO in LO 9. The last thing in LO 9. Firstly, we need to know that we talk about ideal fluids, not real fluids. What is the difference between ideal fluid and real fluid? We assume that some property of ideal fluid and talk about it as a standard to our fluids. First thing. Fluids are steady or laminar flow. We know that velocity of our fluid is constant in speed and direction and in laminar or steady flow. Second property of ideal fluid is incompressible. Most of our fluids have this constant density and incompressible, such as water, kerosene, alcohol, mercury. Third property, non-viscous. There is no friction between the layers or molecules of our fluid. We can describe the flow of our fluid gas or liquid by streamline. Streamline show the path of our fluid in its direction, as we see in these figures. Sorry, as we see in this pictures here. Okay. Bernoulli equation, the last topic, the last learning outcome in LO9. Talk about conservation of energy. The energy and the input equal the energy, the total energy in the output. In this tube, we have work done to push our fluid to this tube, and in the output we have another work of this fluid when we go out this tube. Okay, the difference in work must equal the kinetic and potential energy of our fluid inside this tube. Okay, how we can calculate the difference in work? Firstly, we calculate work inside, work 1, W1. W1 equal F1 delta X1, and we can substitute F1 by B1 A1. So W1 equal B1 A1 delta X1. And work 2 in the output equal F2 delta X2, by the same way equal B2 A2 delta X2. A here is cross sectional area, and B the pressure in the input and output. Okay, A1 dx1 and A2 dx2 equal delta V here, delta volume. V here means volume, and the volume go in our tube equal the volume go out, because it ideal fluid, it's laminar flow. So volume flow rate is constant, and the volume go in equals the volume go out. So network equal W1 minus W2, it's equal P1 delta V minus B2 delta V. The network and the fluid is network equal change in kinetic energy plus change in potential energy, the change in energy of our fluid. Now we can substitute kinetic energy equal half mv square and potential energy equal mg y. Y here is the height of our tube. As we see, the derivation of Bernoulli equation, I think it's clear here, right by hand, and I think it's very good. Okay, let's go to another thing, another application, example and application of Bernoulli's principle. If our fluids at rest means velocity equals zero, so we can cancel term half rho v square in Bernoulli equation, and as we see, p1 minus p2 delta b equal rho g y2 minus y1 and equal rho g h. I think it's pressure in static pressure. Okay. Second application. Consider a pipe with multiple diameters, a change in diameter, but at the same height. So y2 and y1 equal zero here. We can cancel the term half y2 or y1. As we see, p1 plus half rho v1 square equal b2 plus half rho v2 square. Because pressure and velocity velocity square here, the sum of it equal constant, any increase in one side in pressure, for example, decreases the velocity and the opposite thing. So if the pressure decreases, the speed increases, and the opposite. It's okay. I think it's very good. Now, if we have a tank and this tank have a small hole in the bottom, by applying Bernoulli's equation between one and the surface of the liquid inside tank and two in the outside, or in the outside of our hole, p1 equal p2, it's equal atmospheric pressure here. Okay, we can cancel that. So half rho v1 square plus rho gy1 equal half rho v2 square plus rho gy2. By calculating, we can have rho gy1 minus rho g y2, it's rho g h here, and by calculations we can get the velocity of our fluid go out this hole equal square root 2 g h. Okay, as we see, I think it's simple. V1 here equals zero because our fluid inside the tank didn't move, have velocity equal zero. Okay, but go out with velocity by this equation. Another application of Bernoulli's equation in ideal life, as we see, because the pressure difference between inside and outside pressure that result due to increase in kinetic energy and the potential energy is constant, there will be decreases in pressure, decrease in pressure on the surface. So in the tornado, because of the wind have high velocity, it have low pressure inside the tornado. He can destroy any building by this way, okay?
So that thing?
Venturi flow, another application about Bernoulli's equation, okay? Venturi flow meter used to calculate the velocity or of aircraft and the velocity of fluid inside the pipe or anything. Okay, change in pressure result in net force toward low pressure region. Okay, and this is simple kind of this Venturi meter. The Venturi tube consists of a plain tube with a smooth construction in its pore at the middle. It's found in carburetor, I think, floats flow meter, and in aircraft airspeed indicator. When high pressure air is applied from the air tank, the water level in the 3 manometer legs is clearly different. A U-tube filled with water connected to both the narrow and wider part of a glass cylinder. When high pressure air stream flows through the cylinder, the water rises toward the narrower part of the cylinder. By the difference in height in this legs, we can calculate pressure and the velocity of the air inside this tube. Okay. Now another application: why the tennis ball stands in the air if we pump air from the bottom to up? This ball stands in the air. Sometimes people thought that the ball isn't being pushed up by the air from the dryer, as one may think. Instead of air moving over the ball, surface creates low pressure above the ball. But that how? In this picture, I think it's easy. When our air flow from two sides, it's make low pressure from two sides here, from right side and left side. Pressure decreases from the sides, and net force towards up equal to gravity force. So it stand in the air and didn't flow, didn't fall down. Okay. Oh, it's a very important application in Bernoulli's equation. How do planes stay in the air? How it fly? How plane work and why it can't fly in atmospheric flexion. This is explanation. The air on top of the wings must travel a longer distance than the air below the wings, but air on both sides must reach to the end of the wing at the same time. So the air on the top of the wings traveling faster. More velocity means less on air pressure. So the atmospheric pressure above the wing less than the atmospheric pressure below the wing, and it produces force come from down to up in the wing. Okay? And this is another explanation to this lifting force. Okay. Now, when rabbits digging a hole underground, they can breathe in this holes or in these tunnels. How? In this picture, I think it's easy. The velocity of wind or air outside make difference in pressure in the two sides or two holes of this tunnel, so the air can flow inside this tunnel and rabbits can breathe. One end of the gopher hole is higher than the other, causing a constriction and low pressure region. Thus, the air is constantly sucked out of the higher hole by the wind. The air enters the lower hole, providing a sort of air recirculating system effect to prevent suffocation. Okay. By the same way, the perfume sprayer works. When the air passes through here by high velocity, pressure decreases and the perfume go up in this tube because the pressure decreases and can go out from here. Okay. This is solved example, solved problem about Bernoulli equation. You can read it and solve it with own yourself. And this is another solved problem with its solution. To see how we can calculate and answer this kind of problem. You can pause this video and see this problem carefully, because we have some practice in this video, in the end of this video, and we need to answer these questions. Okay? Another one was its answer. Now we have some problems that I need you to solve it and send me the answer of this problems. It's very important to you and to us. Thank you all. I hope I help you in this topic. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.